Alessia and I just made a basketball hoop and it even stands. And we made a ball like this and it goes into the hoop. Dribble, 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 slam dunk. Ooh, I got it. Cool.
Hey everyone, greetings from my hotel room. I'm performing this weekend at the Chowchilla Madera Fair in Chowchilla, California, and this is the basketball hoop that I designed with Alessi, and it's rather complex, and I have a feeling some of you are going to say, teach an easier version. So, before I teach this one, I'm going to show you a much easier, quick, simple basketball hoop that even has a net, and it stands like this, and you can even shoot baskets. Whoosh. Or this slightly more rectangular one. And what's cool about these is that they actually fly as a plane. It even flies as a paper airplane. Check it out. And I'm also going to show you this other version of the basketball hoop that's like this. And this one also flies. The basketball hoop paper airplane. Yeah. And then I'm going to show you the complex one. So if you want to learn how to fold this, then skip to here. For the easy one, ready, set, here goes. So for this hoop, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of commie, but you could use any square. Begin white side up and fold in half. Unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. If I'm going too fast, press the pause button. Now fold this flap up to this edge. And repeat. And now fold this flap on this line. Unfold and turn over and fold this edge to this edge. Unfold and fold this edge to this edge. Unfold and now pinch the corners like this and bring it up and flatten. So it's like this. And rotate and now fold this edge down to this edge, but just make a pinch mark right there. Unfold and fold this flap to that pinch mark. And fold this flap to this point. And insert the flap into the pocket. Either pocket's fine. Like that. And round out your hoop. And so that it won't fall down like that, we're just going to fold this edge to the crease. And repeat. And there is the hoop. And now if you want to make a ball, just get some toilet paper, one square of toilet paper, and just one ply. And now wrap it up into a ball. That's going to be too big for that hoop, so I'm going to take some away. Okay, here goes. Oh, and if it doesn't go through, you can just adjust it by sliding this apart, and then it'll go through. Like that. So there's the basketball hoop and the basketball. And it even flies as a paper airplane. Check it out. I gotta give it some lift by folding this edge up. Okay, now let's try. Oh yeah. Ooh, it did flips. Now if you want it flatter on top, like this basketball hoop, then all you have to do is open up here and fold this behind, like this. And turn over, and there it is, flatter on top. But uh-oh, the hoop's upside down. No problem, we can fix that. Just unfold here, and unfold this flap, and repeat. And now fold like this and fold down here and refold over there and repeat on this side. And fold this flap like this so that this and this are parallel and this point touches the edge. And fold this flap over like that. And once again, insert it into the pocket. And round it out. And you have a hoop that's more square on top. And if you want it a little bit wider, well, all you have to do is pull this flap out and squash and repeat. And you can fold like this. And now you have a wide hoop. And to make it fly, what you want to do is fold this flap like this and fold it back and repeat on this side. And now fold these flaps together and fold this edge to here and repeat. And now we have an airplane that you can fly like this. And now just take this edge and fold it behind. How much? That much. And remake the pleats. And it's ready to fly. And to fly it, you just hold it like this and whoosh, like this. Yeah. So there you have it. And now I'm going to show you how to fold the complex basketball hoop. Here goes. So here's the basketball hoop that I designed with Alessi. It has a square base and it stands nicely and you can even play basketball. So for this model, I'm going to use 10-inch square pommy. For a white hoop with a blue stand and a blue rectangle, begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. And this is a rather complex model, so if you're new to folding, well, hopefully you folded the first one. And unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. And fold to the edge. And repeat. We're folding into eighths. And turn over and fold to the crease. And repeat. And now fold this flap up like this and repeat. And fold this flap up over the edge and unfold and now reverse fold like that and flatten and repeat. Now fold this flap up, aligning it with this edge, but we're not going to fold all the way across. Just fold into the crease. And unfold and repeat. And unfold, and unfold these two flaps. And now we're going to work on this end. So just make a paper airplane fold. Try to make it as perfect as possible. Hold the layers together so that they don't slide. Unfold, and now we're going to reverse fold all four of these flaps. So, open the front flap and push it in and pinch. So it's like that. And reverse this flap like this. Just push it in and repeat. Now fold these two flaps up like this and bring them back down. And now hold on to the front flap and this flap and pull apart like this and pinch on the crease. And now pinch these two edges together, and these two edges together, and flatten it like this. And repeat on this side. Pull apart, and pinch on the crease. And pinch these two edges and these two edges and flatten. Okay. Now fold this flap up to this crease and it's going to lift up here. And squash it so that we're squashing right on this point. So it's like that. And now fold this flap down so that this edge aligns with this edge. Like that. And repeat on this side. So fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the crease. And you can also try to make these flaps overlap perfectly. And now squash it like this. And fold this flap over. And now fold these two flaps together. Okay, now fold this flap inside the pocket so that the edge aligns with this edge on the inside, like that. And now fold the flap over so that this edge aligns with this edge. like that, and repeat. Okay, so it's like this, and now open this pocket, and we're going to squash the top like this, both pockets, and squash it down, and now fold the top down like this. You don't need to flatten it sharply here, and unfold and reach in here and squash. So here's our rectangle, except now it's a square. So fold the bottom down to taste, however big you want the rectangle. And now to make it flatten a little bit better, you can fold this flap inside the pocket. So we're wrapping it over this edge and inside the pocket. And repeat. All right, we'll connect these later. Now we're going to narrow the pole. So we're going to make this fold, not all the way across. We're going to fold so that this edge aligns with this point and this is 90 degrees. And fold like this to there and unfold and repeat on this side. And pinch those together like this. And we have the folds here, make those. And flatten it like this. And now we're going to pleat sink this to make it narrower. So fold this edge to here. Hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And rotate and fold this flap to the top. Turn over and fold all of these layers to here. Good luck. This is why this model is complex. And if you're having trouble with this next step, well, I recommend the two interlocking rings here. That's the prerequisite. Here goes pleat sinking. Unfold and unfold. So it's like this. Turn over, and here we have this rectangle, the outer rectangle. That's what we're looking at. So pinch like this. Notice how my finger is behind to provide support. And now we're going to go around like this. So notice how my fingers are behind to provide support. And I'm just pinching along this rectangle. This is a kind of challenging step. And if you're having trouble, I recommend that you pull the two interlocking rings because that's a lot easier and it's the same general concept. All right, so we get to here and we just keep on pinching around. And like this. So the first rectangle is pinched. So we managed to go around the rectangle. And now we're going to go on the next rectangle, like this. It might be easier to do it from this side. So now we're pinching on this rectangle. And now that it's like this, we're going to do the last rectangle inside here and turn over, and here goes. Pinch, pinch, pinch. And pinch, pinch, pinch. And the pleat sinking is complete. And now fold up like this. And just flatten this really well. So it's like that. And now fold this flap up like this and like this. All right, so here it is with a square base, but it falls right over. So what we're going to do to make it not fall is just fold this edge over. This is to taste, so that you have some height onto the platform, like that, and repeat on this side. Maybe you could fold right on that point. And now fold this flap over the edge and unfold, and we're going to insert it, but there's an easier way to do that. All you have to do is lift this flap up, and now it's easy to slip inside, like that. And do the same on this side. Fold over the edge, and unfold, and open here, and put it inside. And repeat here, too. Okay, and now fold this flap up like this, and like this, and repeat on this side, fold up, we're folding right on the corners, and open like this, carefully forming a box. Just pinch right along the existing crease. Like that. And now it should stand. Yes. If it doesn't stand, well, I recommend instead of having it like this, you can actually open up here and just curve it. Make it so that it's a round pole, like a real pole. And same over here. So it's like this, and that should hold it together a little bit better. And it'll also let you kind of bend it easily forward, like that, so it'll definitely stand. Okay, now let's bring the hoop together. So just insert one inside the other. I recommend that you make the curvature like this, so that way the two ends won't pull on each other. All right, now it should be a little bit easier to insert in. Well, if you can open the pocket. Okay. There we go. And there's the hoop. And once again, for the ball. There's the hoop, there's the ball, and There's the basket. And maybe, if you're lucky, it can even go off the backboard. Ta-da! A layup. A slam dunk. And there you have it. All right, hope you guys managed to make this and have fun shooting hoops. See you guys later.
Alessi just figured out something else that it can be. Tell us about it.
It's a slingshot.
You put the ball on the basket and then hold it back and dun-da-da, waya. Yeah, cool. Alessi and I just made a basketball hoop and a person dunking. A basketball hoop and a basketball player. And slam dunk, waya.
Now he's stuck in the hoop.
Yikes, oh no, let me go. No, I will not let you go. Ah, I escaped.
Maybe I have to fold this over. I'm gonna fold this back. So it's like this. And this one also flies. Oh yeah. Waya! The basketball hoop paper airplane. Yeah.